This had to be, again, a difficult game to call because right at the very beginning of the game, he had that great tipped interception. You're like, all right, here we go. We're off to the races. This is going to be a fun, fast, and furious one with some defensive plays. Hopefully the offense can go ahead and match the defensive efforts. And then, blah, the offense does nothing. The defense is getting run on every other play. Was this a hard one to call for you, not just as a former player but as a new broadcaster?
It was a hard second half. The first half, actually, all things considered, the defense played fairly well. They had one drive against them the whole first half, and it wasn't even, you know, a great drive. I thought, from my vantage point, looking down at it, the defense, Dean Pease had a great scheme. If they execute it the way it was supposed to be executed, they don't sniff the end zone. You know, they don't even get close, and they didn't. They kicked a bunch of field goals as well. So, I mean, you got to hand it to the defense for that. The second half was a little bit different story. But, you know, when you're waiting for your defense to make all the plays and you don't even have a hope for your offense to make plays, it's not a good formula.
And one of the storylines that have been going on for the last few weeks is, especially with the missed tackle last week and giving up the big play.
Yeah.
Giving up the big play.
Yeah.
And it's like you can play great, and, you know, then you give up the big play. And then our sports guy, you know, Keith brought up a great point, is that we haven't been able to have a team give up any big plays to us. We don't have any, because one or two big plays for us could change the complexity of, you know, all these games. And it's like, we're the ones always giving up the big play. We're never getting the big play and having another team make a mistake and or, you know, outsmarting another team or having a great route and having them give up the big play.
There's so many factors that go into play. There's personnel. I mean, you look at Joe Flacco. I mean, he got sacked 5 times.
Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't have enough time to sit back there and get it down the field. And you have to create other ways to do it. And they tried, you know, jet sweeps. They tried little handoffs and little trick'em stuff in the backfield that wasn't that sophisticated in the first place. But it's just that there's not enough guys that can go up and make plays down the field. And Joe doesn't have that rapport with any of those guys or the you know any previous success to say we can go do that and have confidence in doing it down the field. And it's just. They're going to have to eventually start putting the ball in the air and also just to back the defenses off, but also to help with the running game, because our running game has to be our strong suit at this point. And we didn't run the ball enough. You know, we ran, obviously you're down, you have to throw the ball, but you know, we've got a couple guys that are fairly capable in our offensive line. That's probably our strong suit right now. And you have to use what you're best at, and, you know, we weren't able to get that done yesterday for sure.
We're talking to number 86. He is a Ravens Ring of Honor member, Todd Heap. And if you were, Todd Heap, to transport yourself onto this team as a current and active player, you're a tight end on this team with everything that has happened, what is your feeling at this point? What is your number one overall emotion, your sense for what's going on? If Todd Heap is playing on this team and the way the season has shook out this far, week 7, you're thinking what?
My personal mindset was always, I've got to be the guy to make something happen. You know, like we haven't made any plays. Okay, I'm putting it on my shoulders to make something happen. And that's how it has to be across the board to a man, every guy in the locker room. I've got to put it on my shoulders to make something happen. I'm the reason why we're not having success. And everybody has to have that mentality in order to get out of this hole. I mean, the second you start looking to somebody else or worrying about, okay, this guy didn't perform well, you can't do that in the locker room. You've got to point the finger squarely at yourself and figure out what you can do to make your team better, and go to work. You know, that the mindset has to be, let's go to work. Let's figure out what we can do. You know, get together with the team and really, really come in with everything you got for the week of practice. And you know, it's hard to get out of these slumps, but that's the way you have to approach it.